Mr. President, in June this year, you took the important step to sign the valuable 500 commitment, putting disability inclusion high up on the EIB leadership agenda. Do you have any direct experience with disability from your work, studies, or even from your private sphere? What is that made you realize that disability inclusion is not merely an ethical imperative, but is indeed a wise investment that can only bring positive returns to the economy and society overall?
I have been in touch with the issue on all the three dimensions which you mentioned. Like almost all of us, disability has also touched my life personally, friends and family, and even myself, temporarily, thank God only. These were clear experiences of being at odds with our society and requiring some small yet deeply human adjustments. For the EIB group, this means providing working conditions that allow everyone to express their uniqueness and diverse talents. We know that more diverse and inclusive organizations are simply more creative, more innovative, and in the long run, as you have said, more competitive. Disability inclusion is not only an ethical imperative, it is a real economic imperative for societies and organizations. And at the EU Bank, disability inclusion is a clear priority.
Dear President, what do you think can be done to make the bank more appealing for professionals with disabilities or professionals who have family members with disabilities?
This is why the EU Bank, especially during this last year, which was very difficult, has significantly intensified its efforts in this field. And this is because we strive to make disability inclusion not only possible, but a real asset for the bank. Of course, this is an ambitious goal that requires commitment. It's a long way to go. It concerns all phases of an employee's life in the bank, and this starts right at the application process. And this in turn means being able to develop working arrangements that allow for the expression of different sets of skills and talents. The individual's experience is therefore at the heart of this new approach to disability. Again, the main goal remains to enable everyone to excel, whatever their starting point.
We have noticed an increased attention in the EIB's investment operations for projects around disability. How can we ensure that the EIB's investments in the field focus not only on projects for persons with disabilities, but with persons with disabilities?
We address disability considerations and promote inclusion in four ways. First, ensure that disability considerations are fully integrated in the technical preparation of the projects that we finance. Secondly, we support operations and projects that directly address disability and inclusion. Thirdly, we promote the employment of persons with disability by requiring promoters and contractors to comply with the principle of non-discrimination and equal treatment. Finally, persons with disability should be able to actively participate in the stakeholder engagement process in all phases of the project. I would like to thank you for the work that you have done to date to establish and develop the Enable Network. It is so important. You have become a respected and representative voice for our colleagues with disabilities, and sometimes you should challenge our services. It is very appreciated that you have yet again gone the extra mile to ensure that we are continually improving on our disability inclusion credentials. And for the future, I have no doubt that we should expect many positive developments that we can all be proud of at the EU Bank. So thank you very much.